What else are you taking on a regular basis?
I am very well known for taking creatine. So creatine is a wonderful, wonderful supplement. It's the cheapest and most well-studied supplement on the market, the cleanest. It's a naturally occurring molecule in our body, in the liver, but we don't get enough of it to cater for what we need. And there's a twofold effect here, right? We, over the last 50 years, we knew of creatine as being this bodybuilding drug, right? This supplement that is there to help you grow bigger muscles. And we knew it was good for the body, but we now have substantial evidence to show that creatine is great for the brain. Why is that? Because it helps with cell energy metabolism. Well, what does that mean? Well, within the cell, okay, within the mitochondria, you actually produce ATP, which is the main energy current of the cell. When you eat food, it actually gets broken up into pieces. And when it goes through the mitochondria, we use the mitochondria, if functioning well, we use that for energy. We can actually help the mitochondria produce more energy through creatine because it helps produce it in that. So you're producing more cell energy in the brain. What does the literature say? Well, we've got preclinical studies to show the effects of creatine as a neuroprotective molecule. So it protects the neurons against what we call insults. Insults are things such as head trauma. So NFL athletes, they're doing studies where they're actually dosing them prior to the game with 20 grams of creatine. Now, if you're not getting hit in the head, you don't need to have, you know, this large of a dose. But that just shows that it acts as a protective barrier for the cells when they are going out and getting hit. But an insult, actually, Jesse, is also a stroke. Strokes are common in females as well, more common than men. So you can protect yourself against maybe suffering a stroke or getting any type of insult that occurs. Even an insult is like a headache or going outside and being insulted, if you will, by the toxins in the air. So you are protecting the brain in that instant as well. And then in terms of the twofold effect, you think about what it means as a woman as we get older and we go through that menopausal state. What's happening? Well, we have no estrogen being produced. And estrogen is one of those neurotrophins that is protective for the brain. We have estrogen receptors in our brain. But we also see that a lot of these women in the postmenopausal state are becoming osteopenic. So creatine can actually help with bone mass density. So you're also helping protect and serve the bone mineral density, I should say. Yeah.
Is there a standard dose you like to recommend to adults across the board?
Yeah. By the way, anyone can take this. And it doesn't matter what age you are. I always recommend like 12 years and up. And if you want the benefits from a physiological standpoint, meaning like a physical standpoint in your body, I say just have 5 grams a day. Right. But if you want the cognitive benefits, you want to up it to around 10 to 12 grams. And that's because the bioavailability is generally lost when it crosses the blood-brain barrier. So you want to up that to around 10 to 12 grams per day. And it doesn't degrade in heat. So you can have creatine in your coffee, which is where we sneak it into my dad's coffee, mom and I. Every morning I'm like, did you sneak it in? She's like, I did. And he feels great and he just thinks it's the coffee. So it's amazing. So you can put it in your morning coffee. You can put it in your morning smoothie. You can put it in your water. It doesn't have any taste. Some of the myths around it is it causes hair loss. We've debunked that. It doesn't increase DHT, doesn't cause any kidney issues. There was a study done by Dr. Darren Kandel where he took women and he put them on a protocol of daily for 2 years, having, I think it was 12 grams of creatine per day. And he saw massive increases in bone mineral density and muscle mass, no bloating, no hair loss, no kidney issues.
If somebody is going to take the higher doses for the cognitive benefits, you mentioned 10 to 12 grams a day, is it beneficial to split that up in 2 or 3 doses and spread it out?
You can, or you don't have to. It just really depends on how you feel. You can't slap a label on something saying one size fits all. We're all different. if you feel like you are getting bloated or it's causing any type of gastrointestinal distress, maybe wean off it a little bit. Like, you have to listen to your body. For me, I actually have 5 grams a day, but if I've got a heavy cognitive load, for example, I'm writing a systematic review right now, which, let me tell you, is a marathon for your brain. There's around 3,000 articles that I've got to go through and write about, and there's a lot of cognitive load. On those days where I know I'm going to be reading for 12 hours a day, I'll have 12 grams. And I will separate that as well. 5 grams in the morning, 5 grams at around, I don't know, 6 p.m. And if you're having it for the benefits of the gym, people generally ask, well, should I have it just before the gym? It really doesn't matter. The storage is the storage.
And if you forget it, say you're traveling, you don't bring it with you, do you notice a big difference on those days?
Oh, I'm known for being like prolific with my supplements. When I travel, you should see it. I never forget, but that's just me. But for the people that do, they do see a difference in how they feel, especially in terms of how well they're lifting and how heavy they're lifting.
If you enjoyed that clip, you're going to want to head over here and catch a full episode. I'll see you over there.
Your brain cells really have this notion of supply and demand. It's under so much demand every day, from work stress to environmental stress. But if you have a lot of supply through ketones and through...